can think of bonds as substitutes. Just like the red pin is a substitute here for the green pin, the government bonds are substitutes for the corporate bonds. The German bonds are a substitute for the US bonds, and the 10-year T-note is a substitute for the 5-year T-note. So they influence each other. Just like when the price of red pins goes up, it affects the demand for the green pins. The demand for the green pins go up, and the price of the green pins go up. So the price of green pins falls, the price of the red pins falls. Same thing with bonds. They're closely related that way. Price of one goes up, the other one goes up too. So remember, bonds that are close related. The 5-year bond is very similar to a 10-year bond. When you think about it, if you want to buy a bond, aren't they similar? Just one's a little bit longer term than the other one. The German bonds are substitutes for the US government bonds. So if you're in China and you're thinking about investing in bonds, you're looking outside of China. Well, should you buy the German ones for 10 years or buy the US bonds? They're pretty close. Probably the same risk of default, which is very small. Which one are you going to buy? Well, you're probably going to look at the interest rate. That's one of the things you're going to be looking at. Who's paying a higher interest rate? Then you're also going to be looking at things like the currency exchange rate. The dollar may change against the yuan, the German may change more. And so they're having to make this decision about which ones they should buy. Okay, well, let's take a look at this. So let's say here, we have a supply of bonds in both countries. And we have a demand for bonds, the 10 years, in both countries. We'll have price on the vertical axis here. So the price of the US government bonds here, the price of the German Bunds over here. They're substitutes. Let's say that the Germans decide they're going to issue more bonds. They need to borrow money from the government for some reason or another. So that increases the supply of the German Bunds. The quality of them is the same. Nothing else has changed. They just increase the supply of them. We should see a new equilibrium very, very quickly. We should see the price fall. So supply increases by issuing more bonds, and we should see the price of them fall. And what about the yield? The yield goes in the opposite direction, so the yield should increase. So they're paying a little higher interest rate now than they were before. They're substitutes. Someone who's looking at these two markets are saying, wow, the yield, the Germans are paying a higher interest rate now. Makes them look more attractive than the US bonds aren't paying as good of an interest rate. All else equal, wouldn't you want to have a higher interest rate on the bonds you're buying? So now the demand falls for the US bonds. We get to a new equilibrium quickly. Demand falls. And as a result, the price falls of the US bonds. And as the price falls, the yield on them goes up. So by what the Germans are doing over there, something over there that's made their interest rates go up, has made our interest rates go up too. So we're that closely connected to what's going on outside of the United States for these bonds, especially the longer term bonds, like the 10 years that tend to be a lot internationally determined. Interest rates start going up around other places, other countries in the world. It makes our interest rates going up. Their interest rates start falling. It makes our interest rates start falling over here. And at the same token here, if the yield on the 10-year goes up over here in the United States for the 10-year, what do you think is going to happen to the 5-year? They're substitutes too. Their price is going to fall too, and their yield will go up. What's going to happen to the corporate bonds here in the U.S.? They're substitutes for the government bonds or the municipal bonds. They're all substitutes to some degree. The yield starts going up on the government bonds, and it raises the yield on the corporate bonds too, the municipal bonds. The yield goes up on these government bonds. It makes it a little more expensive for cities to borrow, makes it more expensive for corporations to borrow. It'll increase the short-term interest rates too. So yields start going up in Germany. It makes our yields start going up here, makes all our yields going up, the short-term bonds, the government bonds, interest rates in general start going up, makes it a little more expensive for people over here than to start to buy a house. The mortgage rates might start going up too. The interest rate you have to pay to buy a car might start going up too. So we're closely connected to what's going on in the rest of the world because these are all substitutes. And as I said, if the interest rates on the bonds change, interest rates don't act alone. They all kind of go up together. They all kind of come down together. So if the interest rates on the bonds are going up, it means interest rates for everything in the economy is going up too at the same time. Okay, so what we've done in this video, we've gone over present value and discounting. And the whole purpose of that was to show you how bonds work, because bonds prices act like the present value of some future value in the future. And as interest rates change and the time to the future changes, it changes the present value. Same thing with bonds. So then we went through bonds and the characteristics of bonds that they all have in common, the types of bonds that there are, the yields, which is just the interest rate. Some bonds are riskier than others, so they carry a little risk premium, which means they pay a little higher interest rate. So the riskier bonds that have a greater chance of default means that you earn a little bit more interest on those bonds. And then we went through an example here to show you how when bond prices go up, interest rates or yields on them go down. Yields go up, bond prices go down. So these bond prices that are sensitive to the interest rate are always fluctuating. And that present value price is always set by supply and demand. And when it changes, the yield has to change accordingly, because it's not static. That supply and demand is always kind of moving around and changing that equilibrium, which means that the interest rate is changing. Which means if you're holding these bonds, you're holding them for a long time, the value of them in your account changes too, all the time. And then we went through bonds, how they act as substitutes. And it really is just the same thing as blue pins and green, blue pins and black pins, or red pins and green pins. They're substitutes. And what happens in one market affects the other market. And when the price of one of them goes up, it makes the price of the other one go up.